Okay. I'm gonna start. Nga jumpa napa.
Okay.
Inshallah. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin. Wassalatu wassalam ala Rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Inna alhamdulillah nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh. Wa na'udzu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lahu wa man yudlil fala hadiya lahu. Wa nashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. وقوله سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلوا به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما يا عباد الله اعلموا أن خير الكلام كلام الله وخير هدي هدي محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري وهل الأقدام من لساني يفقه قولي أما بعد الحمد لله رب العالمين today حلقة will start today for today إن شاء الله بإذن الله سبحانه وتعالى today بإذن الله we're going to talk about the hadith من حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم you can find the hadith or narrated by Imam Ahmad and Al-Mustad Al-Tabarani and in Hibani and Al-Hakim min hadith Ibn Abbas qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the night on which he was taken on the night journey of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was going to Ahl Miraj, Isra al Miraj. So when he was with Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam, a beautiful fragrance, mean a beautiful smile, the smell, you know, the beautiful smell, the fragrance come to me. And I said, oh Jibreel, yeah, Jibreel alayhi salam said, what is this beautiful fragrance? And then Jibreel alayhi salam said, this is the fragrance of the hairdresser of Fir'aun's daughter, the daughter of Fir'aun and her hairdresser. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what is the story about this? And then Jibreel is talking right now because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he went to Ahl Miraj, what happened? So, you know, a beautiful fragrance come to him, a beautiful, very good smell. So the Prophet was very surprised. So he asked Jibreel, he said, yeah, Jibreel, what is this? And then Jibreel tell him about, he said, that lady's name Mashita Fir'aun. Mashita Fir'aun, she's the lady who was the hairdresser of Fir'aun's daughter. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Jibreel, he said, yeah, Jibreel, could you tell me the history? Now Jibreel will talk to him, the history. We will listen to Jibreel alayhi salatu wa sallam. And then Jibreel said, Jibreel said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said there was a woman called Mashita Fir'aun. His name was Mashita Fir'aun. She was a woman who was the hairdresser of the daughter of Fir'aun. Who said, the Fir'aun, everybody know Fir'aun, is a man who said to himself, is the king who said, Ya ayyuhal mala'u ma ulimtu lakum min ilahi ghayr
He said to his people, "Oh my people, I didn't know any God than me." Inni Rabbukum A'la. He said he is a God. That's what he said to his people. So, Mashitat Fir'aun, she had embracing Islam in secretly. Nobody didn't know. She embraced Islam secretly. And when she was combing the hair of the daughter of Fir'aun, the king Fir'aun, the one who said he is God, the comb fell down. When the comb fell down to the ground, and then marched up Fir'aun, and then she automatically, subconsciously, pick up the comb. When she pick up the comb, and she said, "Bismillah, in the name of Allah." You see, this is a mu'min, this is a Muslim, even automatically, because every action of a mu'min, everything you're going to do, even something is fragile, you want to do something, you have to start with Bismillah. I want to eat, I want to sit down, I want to take something, I want to drink, I want everything, you have to start first, Bismillah. Bismillah. Mashitat Fir'aun, when she want to pick up the comb, she said Bismillah. So, when she pick up with the name of Allah, this Mashitat Fir'aun, the hairdresser, had 5 children. She has 5 children. And one of them was still breastfeeding. One of them was still breastfeeding. And then the daughter of Fir'aun said, "Allah, Abi, are you saying Allah, my father?" And then Mashitat Fir'aun said, she said, "No, Allah, no. Allah, the God of your father, yourself and me." And she become angry. The daughter of Fir'aun, she become angry because she know her father is God, because her father tell to her, to his people, "Ya ayyuhal mala'u, I'm the God. I didn't show any God, but I'm God." So she born on that way. She saw how her father, everybody bowed, you know, everybody bows down to her father. Then if she see someone who will say, "I know another God," she will be surprised. She say, "What are you talking about?" So what happening? She was very angry. What happening? And then when she was angry, she went to her father and said to him, "Oh father, this woman worship another God beside you." Subhanallah. She went to tell to her father, "This woman worship another God beside you." And then Fir'aun said, he said, "What? What are you talking about? She know another God beside me? Who is that God? Okay, call her to me. He wants to call Mashitat Fir'aun to come to him. Call her to me." And then when they call her, and they call her to him, and then she said, she come and stood up. Look at a woman. She come and stood up Subhanallah. This great king, she was woman. She don't even care. She was servant. Because what? She understand. Because the knowledge, I mean to know your law, Allah, who is, who is Allah? Because to understand my creator, who created me, whom, you know, if you know Allah, and then you know the sweetness of Iman, wallahi, you don't even mountain, you don't care about nothing. Human being, nobody can stand in front of you, because you're gonna shout. You know, there was no like us today. We enjoy Islam in our pocket. We enjoy Islam inside. We don't enjoy Islam outside. We don't practice Islam outside. We just, Islam is become lip service. And I mean lip service. We don't care. But she said, "No, the way she become mu'min, she embrace Islam, she know Allah is my Lord, is my Maker, is my Creator. I'm gonna worship Allah. I don't have any God beside Allah. And then I have to shout everyone, Allah is my Lord and our Lord. She come to stir up front of Fir'aun, a woman. And when a great Fir'aun, she stood up and then he said, Fir'aun said to her, oh, you woman, who is your God? And then she said, Allah is my Lord. And then Fir'aun said, again, who is Allah? Who is that Allah? And then she said, Allahu Rabbi wa Rabbuk. Yes. Allahu Rabbi wa Rabbuk. Allah is my God and your God, in our God. And then she had to answer. And then she answered. This is how the state of mu'min. This is how they ask us to be a believer. Whatever happening, even in mountain, you don't care because you shout your Lord to everyone to see you. To you shout Allah. That the statement of a mu'min, a believer. When they say Allah is my Lord, Rabbi Allah. They went, they start to work. What Fir'aun do to her? Fir'aun start to torture her. We don't care. If small thing happening, we say, no way. I want to change my mind. Quickly. It's very easy to do that right now, today. Small thing, I'm going to change my mind. No. When you said, Allahu Rabbi, wa nahnu, Allah, we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have to state on that belief. You don't go back. You don't look back. You don't go left or right. Be steadfast, firm on who you are. That is our as believer. So when she said Allah is her love, front of Fir'aun, Fir'aun was surprised. Fir'aun, what Fir'aun did? I will tell you what Fir'aun did to her first. What he did, Fir'aun called his people to start to torture her. And then she said the same thing, Allahu Rabbi wa Rabbi. Allah is my God and your God. All of us are God. And then Fir'aun said to his people to bring a chain. Yes. Fir'aun, he want to torture her. He said to bring a chain. They brought a chain. When they brought the chain, and they began to punish her. They punished her and whipped her. And then they asked her again, who is your Lord? She said, Allahu Rabbi wa Rabbu. She don't know. She stay on film. She don't go. No. Because she understand the sweetness. Because, I said that before. I will repeat again today here. I said it. We have two kinds of iman. We have iman and the sweetness of iman. I can, yes, I'm from Muslim family. Oh, I understand Islam. Yes, I have, I'm a believer. I understand Allah is my Lord. It's okay. No, we have the sweetness of iman, mean to understand the sweet, what you're doing, to understand because you're doing something what is going to benefit you. That's a really iman. And then Fir'aun asked her, the time when Fir'aun want to punish her, start to punish her, whip her, Fir'aun asked her again, who's your Lord? She said, Allahu Rabbi wa Rabbu. She stay firm. Subhanallah. We want this today. So Fir'aun ordered for them to bring the large container. Because she Fir'aun bring the chain, start to beat her, to punish her, to torture her. She don't, she's still on the same way. She firm. You understand? So she Fir'aun say now, bring me a container. Bring the container. Yes. Fir'aun said to his people to bring the container. They bring the container. The big container like a swimming pool. The big container. And in the container, what is inside? It was the spilling of hot boiling of oil. in the continent. And then he said, bring me her children. I tell you before, Fir'aun, Majdat Fir'aun had 5 children. Then, now, Fir'aun told to his people to bring all her children. When they bring all her children, and then Fir'aun said to brought them one by one. They start from who? They brought his first son first, the first son. Fir'aun asked her, now I'm gonna ask you again. Yes. And then Fir'aun asked, I am your God. You know what she said? She said, no, never, you are not my God. Allahu Rabbi wa Rabbuk. Yes. And then they took her all that their first son to throw him into the oil in front of her naked eyes. And then his meat and his flesh filled up his body. And then they burned, you know, they start to burn her. You know, she saw her children, her son born in front of her, but she still unfair. She don't give up. She don't give up. And then when they threw her son in the container, and then they brought the next again. The next. And then they asked her same question. She stayed on film. Subhanallah, Allahu Akbar. They burned her. She could not stop. They brought the third one, the fourth one, the final, her fifth one, the one I said she was in breastfeed, was on her arm. She was about to pull back. She was about to pull back. I mean, she was about to give up. She was, because when she look at the sun, you know, she start to have feeling from her heart. She wanna pull back in front of the eyes of the people. When all Sudan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from above 7 sky, made the infant, the children, speak well while he was in the cuddle. He said, Ummati, isbiri ya ummi. Be patient, my mother. Be patient. You are on the truth. Don't give up. Inna Allah qad wa'daki bi jannah. Inna Allah qad wa'daki bi jannah. Allah had promising you with the great heaven. Keep going, mother. Keep going, mother. Don't give up. And then, what happened? They threw her son. The son died. Boiled oil. And then she was the next. Now all the children, they gone. She was the next. What's gonna happen? She's the next. All the children, they gone. They burn her front of her naked eyes. She saw, she it doesn't mean they took her to kill them, you know, somewhere else. No. She was standing and saw her children. They killed them one by one. 5 children, they all gone. Subhanallah. Allahu Akbar. Ya Ibadallah. Let's think about this situation. This is not history, bedtime history. No. Now, this is history. Is Sahih Hadith Sahih? It's true. It doesn't mean we say we read a book today, we see some movie. No, Subhanallah. This happening. This is true. This all those history mean the Prophet tell us. The Al Quran tell us many history in the Quran to us to reflect our iman, to change our iman. Now, because the day when you say, I believe in Allah, is that day the fitna will start. That means we have to understand that. The day when you say, I believe in Allah. Allah, Allahu Rabbi, Allahu Rabbi. That day, the fitna will start. Inna Allah yabluwana wa yabluwakum. Hatta, until he will know who is the sabr, who have the patience among us. Allah said in the Quran, you think he will leave you. You're gonna say from your mouth, from your tongue, or from your mouth, inni, I believe in him, I believe in Allah, without testing you. No, Allah said he will test us to see our iman, to see the way you can be patient, the way you how iman you have in your heart. So this is history, is very important. Now she's the next. She's left. Her 5 children are gone. What happening? Now is she know that she going to die. She know that she going to die. And then she began to cry. And then Fir'aun said, why are you crying? What happening? She said, I'm crying because I want to ask you something to do for me. Because I don't know if you will do it for me or not. And then Fir'aun tell her, yes, ask me whatever you want, you like, I will do it. No, don't worry, ask me. She said, once you throw me into the oil, then I want you to guzzle whatever is remaining of our body, me and my children. And I want you to bury us together in the same grave, because I want you to be resurrected with my children. And I want to go to Jannah with them. I want to resurrect with my children together. Please, I want you to guzzle in us, to accumulate us whatever is remain. Even one bones, even stray, even nothing, just struggling, even it's not born, because something is born, maybe it's gone, nothing we see, right? Even nothing, just accumulate something, just pull us together. I want to be resurrected with my children. And then Fir'aun told her to, no problem, he will do that for her. And then she know what this life is and hereafter. Because Allah say in the Quran, in Surah Al-Du'a, Allah say, وَلَا الْآخِرَةُ خَيْرُ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. So that means this life is something for us. We have to reflect this life. Ya ibadallah, I say something in the khutbah, I will say today, wallahi, you become Muslim is not from accidentally. You become Muslim is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah made you Islam because he wants you to be Islam. Allah made you Islam is not accidentally, because you will, no. You become accidental. Look at, if you know, example, when you put us all in the house, now you wake up, you get up in same house, you don't know. The people, you see them, you don't know them, but they know about you. You understand what I mean? You wake up in the house, many people in the house, They eat whatever they want. I'm talking about halal. You understand? So they know about you, but you don't know about them. You understand? This life is this. I'm gonna tell you something today. You woke up somewhere. They know about you, but you don't know about them. You just wake up. You see yourself amongst them. So ya ibadallah, you become Islam, it's not accidentally. You become Islam is wisdom, is hikmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's hikmah to you to understand. And then Allah gave you Islam without asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah gave you Islam, you was not there. You didn't write any application. Allah, I want to be Christian, I want to be Yahud, I want to be Muslim. No, you just come in this life. Oh, you see yourself in Muslim family, alhamdulillah. You see yourself, I'm a Muslim, alhamdulillah. Or you see yourself, alhamdulillah, Allah guided me, I embrace Islam, mashallah. So this, all this thing is a hikmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This hikmah, you have to do what? This hikmah, what is your ambition to do? Al-Din Islam is not a nationality, it's not tribulation, is action to show Allah, you give me this, thank you. How to thank Allah? La in shakartum, la azidannakum. If you be grateful to Allah, Allah will increase you more. So what you can be grateful to Allah? How? To say every day, I'm Allah, you create me, thank you? No. La. Laysa haza amal. Al-amal huwa al-Islam, you action, you did good. Straight. Adini Islam huwa dinul amali. Adini Islam huwa dinul amali. To read the Quran. Today, Quran become a shaft. We keep it in the shaft, beautiful shaft. Quran, it become in our pocket. Quran is Kitabul Amali. Quran is not Baraka. Quran, you have to work on it. Yes, if you work on the Quran, you will get what you want inside. Today, we write Quran in the world. Quran, it becomes something we put on, our pocket. Now, Quran cannot protect you for that. Quran can protect you for one thing. You have to read it. You know, Umar ibn Khattab, he said, he took 10 years to memorize one surah. 10 years to memorize one surah. So ask yourself how. He said, he had to read first. After read, he had to understand the fiqh of the surah. After that, he had to reflect with it. After that, he had to work on it. After that, he gonna memorize. That took him 10 years. We have a powerful miracle book. Allah grant us. This is a ni'mah Allah give to us. But ni'mah, we said to the ni'mah, no, this ni'mah, you know, is beautiful. I'm gonna put it on a beautiful shelf to keep it. And in Ramadan, I have to take it and then read it. After next Ramadan, I have to take it to read it. Finish. Now, Quran, وَلَخَتَّدَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنِ. We have to reflect with the Quran, to understand the Quran, to know what the Quran is talking about. That's the beauty of Islam. Ya Ibarallah. This whole story to show us Islam is the beauty of Allah. Allah gave to his servant. So we have to work on it. Don't give up. Don't ever give up. Allah didn't create you to give up. Get up and do something. You're gonna fall down, you're gonna get up. You're gonna fall down, you're gonna get up. Don't be a weak mu'min. Be a strong mu'min, inshallah. Today, halaqa is gonna be end here, inshallah. Next Juma, I will do another halaqa. This history is shout to us to reflect with it. It shout to us to how to love your deen. To love Islam. Wallahi, what every calamity we have today, it happened before a lot. There's even a prophet who died, they killed one prophet, they killed him. Look at Umar ibn Khattab. See, he was praying. They killed him. Look at Usman ibn Affan. They cut his hair, they chop his head. Look at Ali ibn Abi Talib. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. They killed them. So, you know, ya Ibarallah, let's, every calamity, every fitna we see today, this fitna already have long time before, even the prophet passed before, you know, it's happening. So it's gonna happen to our time, but be patient. In Allah, Ma'asabirin. Allah is with someone. You know, asabr. Patient. Let's be patient. Let's be patient in the way of worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, thank you very much. Aquli qawli haza. Wastaghfir li zambi. Fa'innahu huwa ghafurur rahim. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Okay, close, inshallah.